Students, today we'll be starting the second chapter of grammar, that is subject and predicate. In our previous chapter, we have already discussed about sentence. What is sentence? A sentence is a group of words that make complete sense. Now, every sentence has two parts, a subject and a predicate. Now, what is subject? The subject is the noun or pronoun about which a sentence is. What is subject? The subject is the noun or pronoun about which a sentence is. And what is predicate? The predicate tells us about the subject or what the subject does. In other words, we must have a subject to speak about and we must say something about that subject. Is it okay? Now, let's clear it with some example. So, our first example is Aditya wrote a letter. In this, what is a subject? Subject is Aditya. And what he did? Wrote a letter. Wrote a letter is your predicate. I play with my friends. I is your subject. And play with my friends is your predicate. Rahul is a strong boy. In this, what is subject? Rahul. Rahul is your subject. And is a strong boy is your predicate. Now let's talk about compound subject and compound predicate. We will talk about compound subject first. The subject in a sentence may occur as a one word or as a phrase. For example, Rita is playing. And this, what is your subject? Rita. This one word is your subject. The captain of the team will come tomorrow. And this, what is your subject? This whole phrase is your subject. The captain of the team is your subject. Now, the little child was shy. In this, what is your subject? The little child is your subject. Now, sometimes a sentence can consist of two or more subjects. The subjects are usually joined by the conjunctions like and, or, both, either, neither, etc. For example, my sister and my brother are going to a park. And this, what is your subject? My sister and my brother are your subjects, and we have joined them with conjunction, that is and. Either Neha or Naina will win the match. And this, what is your subject? Neha and Naina are your subject, and we have joined them with the conjunctions either and or. So what is your compound subject? When a verb has two or more subjects, we say that verb has a compound subject. Now let's discuss about compound predicate. What is compound predicate? The predicate in a sentence may have one word or more than one word. For example, birds fly. In this, what is your predicate? Fly. This one word is your predicate. Rhea is very friendly. In this, what is your predicate? Is very friendly. This whole phrase is your predicate. Sometimes a sentence can consist of two or more predicates. The predicates are usually joined by the conjunctions and, or, neither, either, etc. For example, Varun lives in Gujarat and speaks Gujarati. In this, what is your predicate? Lives in Gujarat and speaks Gujarati. These are your predicates, and we have joined them with and, that is your conjunction. I came, saw and conquered. And this, what is your predicate? Came, saw and conquered. And we have joined them with conjunction, that is and. So now, what is compound predicate? When two or more verbs or verb phrases that share the same subject are joined by a conjunction, we call it a compound predicate. Normally, the subject comes before the verb. However, in some sentence, the subject follows the verb. Let us study about them. In sentences that begin with here or there, the subject usually appears at the end. For example, here is the mall. In this, what is your subject? Mall. Mall is your subject. And where it is coming? It is coming at the end. And there are the two puppies. In this, what is your subject? The two puppies. This phrase is your subject. And where it came? It came at the end. Now, interrogative sentence. An interrogative sentence, the subject follows the auxiliary verb. For example, did the dog bark? In this, what is your subject? Your subject is the dog. And it is followed by did. And did is your auxiliary verb. Have we met before? And this, what is your subject? Your subject is we. And it is followed by auxiliary verb, that is had. Now, to make it easy, we should first change the interrogative sentence into a declarative sentence. For example, did the dog bark? The declarative sentence of this will be the dog barked. Now, you can easily find out the subject over here. Your subject will be the dog. Have we met before? The declarative sentence will be yes, we have met before. And this, what is your subject now? We. Now, it is clear? Now, imperative sentences. In imperative sentences, the subject is you, but it is not usually written or spoken. For example, take this pen. In this, the subject is you, but it is not written or spoken. And same thing with come here. In this, what is your subject? Your subject is you, but it is not written or spoken. Now, let's talk about exclamatory sentences. In exclamatory sentences, the subject comes before the verb. For example, how beautiful the Taj Mahal is. And this, what is your subject? The Taj Mahal. And where it came? It came before the verb. Now, how amazing she looks. And this, what is your subject? Your subject is she. And when it came before the verb, that is looks. Now, to make it easy, let's change this sentence into a declarative sentence. How amazing she looks. The declarative sentence of this will be, she looks very beautiful. So now, what will be your subject? Your subject is she. How beautiful the Taj Mahal is. Let's convert it into a declarative sentence. It is, the Taj Mahal is very beautiful. Now, what is your subject? The Taj Mahal. Now, this is for you. Underline the subject and circle the predicate. The cow gives us milk. In this, what you have to do, you have to underline the subject and you have to circle the predicate. Bhopal is the capital of Madhya Pradesh. Please cut the fruits. Monica studied hard and cleared the exam. The apples and the grapes are good for health. So, students, I hope you have understood this chapter.